Oh, I got still well, my portrait in my face there. Huh. Hi. Hello, welcome once again to Toy Soldiers Old School. This is episode 66, The Battle of Evergleam, Part 2. My name is Diane Morrison. I am the creator of the Toy Soldier Saga and the author of this big fat book right here, which we're getting really close to apparently having enough to read. There's a community challenge up right now to read the first part live on air, and we just reached the halfway point, so thank you everyone who has contributed to the challenge so far. Online, I'm known as Sable Aradia, obviously, and I am the game master for this game at the moment. Aaron and I change it off periodically. I also play Captain Celine Wintermist. She has somehow ended up in charge of this ragtag bunch of weirdos who are part of the Avalonian Imperial Marine Corps. She joined the forces in order to see the universe and maybe help some people out along the way as an idealistic young priestess of the star and moon goddess. My and her pronouns are she or they. And we'll go over to Rowan.
Hi, I'm Rowan. I play Lady Von Vinstarsong, an ensign in the Elven Imperial Marines, or the Avalonian Imperial Marines. Originally, she joined the Navy. She wanted to fly on starseed ships, see the universe, meet new creatures and plants, and see new planets, but then she wound up with Bugsuit and is now part of the Marine Corps and the ship's druid, and she's found some family and some friends. And her pronouns are she, her, and so are mine.
Awesome. Let's go over to Taz.
Hi, I'm Taz, also known as GMinNo99 on the internet. I play Arden Spellsword, a Magus Kensai person who's obsessed with crafting. That's about it.
And pronouns?
Oh, yeah. Pronouns are he, him.
Awesome. And we'll go down to Chris.
I'm Chris. I play Arian. He is the slightly older, more grizzled actual Marine out of the group. He signed up to be a Marine, not a sailor. He sees it as his job to keep these youngsters alive. He's pretty much a straight fighter with a little bit of magic mixed in. And our pronouns are he, him.
Awesome. And Aaron?
Hi, I'm Aaron. I'm known online as Aaron Ree. Right, which is spelled exactly as it sounds, R-I-G-H. Right. I play the part of Ruavel Sunfall, who is destined to become the father of the protagonist of the Toy Soldier Saga books. He is a paladin, right, of the Moon Goddess. And our pronouns are he, they.
Awesome. And Dawn?
Hi, I'm Dawn. I play Yasma Snowwind. I was a orphan, but joined the Marines for the heck of it and found out I have family. I have a dad and sisters, and apparently I'm the heir to the throne. So, you know, that's kind of cool. And our pronouns are she, her.
Awesome. And Blake?
Hi, I'm Blake. I'll be playing the part of Crowley, Phenoc, feline-like race of my own creation. Crowley joined the Navy along with Yasma, and since became a Marine in a bug suit. Having a bunch of fun, and our pronouns are he, him.
Awesome. And Siobhan.
Hello, I'm Siobhan the writer. I'll be playing Lieutenant Don't Call Me Lilith Madrillian, an altruistic young elf who joined the Avalonian Imperial Navy out of family obligations, has since been transferred over to the Marines because of his bug suit qualifications. And he's looking at starting his own dark ops group. Was originally looking into intelligence, but Dark Ops seems to fit better. My pronouns are she, her. My pronouns are he, they.
Awesome. And we do something fairly unique in this particular game. We have what we call our chat crew. For 100,000 channel points, you can select the I want to play option, and basically you get a semi-PC, right? They're sort of important NPCs, and they get to act and make decisions. We do keep an eye on the chat for that, and often they have a real bearing on the outcome. For the most part, at the moment, this means that you get to play part of the ship's crew of the Void Chaser, which is their starfaring ship that they operate. And since I know we have at least one brand new person in the chat, hi Foxwriter, good to see you, thank you for joining us. If you are confused at any point, feel free to ask. We don't mind answering the questions. But this is magic sailing ships in space. The technology is about not quite Napoleonic Wars. It's more in this option, kind of like the Spanish Armada type level. And yeah, so it's black powder fantasy, basically, but also space opera.
With a little bit of steampunk mixed in.
Yep, a little bit of steampunk. Yeah, that's absolutely true. Yeah.
Sorry, we already have our head chef. That's Crowley.
That's true. That is true. calls dibs his head chef. That's awesome. Yeah. Anyway, we will be consulting them from time to time. You will see a little drum with sticks beating in the bottom corner there. What that means is that we are actively in combat. It's custom on Navy ships to beat to quarters when you are in combat, and that is what that means. We are in combat, and therefore we are not paying attention to antics in the chat. We are concentrating on the fight, right? So sometimes the chat crew likes to have a good time, do goofy stuff, and it's great to bring a little levity to the situation, but we will pay attention to them if what they're doing is relevant to the combat at this point, but we will not pay attention if they're doing goofy stuff at the moment. So, yeah. All right.
I hate to say this, Fox, but we already have a sous chef, too.
Can we get the... I guess you're still the intelligence officer, so let's get the intelligence officer's report and bring people up to date.
Intelligence officer's report supplemental. Shit's going to hell.
Nice. Nice. Currently, they are attempting to defend the city-state of Evergleam, which is an important starfaring port on the world of Talasia, against a massive invasion by an orcish, goblin, ogre combined army. Well, navy, because they came from the sky. We are outnumbered and probably outgunned. The characters made a questionable deal before the fight broke out, which at least made the goblin stand down, which means we might have a chance. So that is what is happening at the moment. And we're actively, the party is currently split. For the most part, the women of the party, because they are secretly imperial princesses, whisking away the king of Evergleam to a safe place, but they don't know that a switcheroo has been played on them, because the king actually, of course, feels an obligation to fight. They think that a guy who has been shape-changed, who is like the general, right, to look like the king, is standing his place. They're wrong, but they don't know that yet.
I know. We know that. We know that,
Fox. I know. They knew too. These are all seasoned players. They know what they're doing. Yeah. They knew what they were getting into. They just thought it was realistic according to roleplay. So, right. Yeah. Facts, though. Yeah, facts. Don't ever split the party. That's when the bad shit happens, as it's about to. All right. So, I believe we were in mid-turn, and I still have the initiative all organized here. Aren't I smart?
Yay!
I even have which orcs are wounded at the moment.
Good.
And you managed to keep it safe from the paper-eating banshee.
Yes, I did. I managed to keep the dog from eating it. It was awesome. So,
Eventually it takes up my desk.
Leave Banshee alone. She's sleeping peacefully right now.
Realism in stories I call hacks. Yeah, no doubt. That's great. All right, so we were about to start a new round, weren't we? Oh, yes, and I had to roll for the new bad guys on the scene. That's what happened.
Yeah, I do believe that you had said that, you know, the spellcasters were now all coming out to play.
Yep.
And that the more advanced troops, in terms of experience, had noticed that we were causing shit, weren't it?
Yep, that's right. So things are about to get interesting. Okay.
So yeah, it's, but by the way, it's only been like 18 seconds since the fight started, technically.
Yeah. Rounds are always kind of a mystery to me that way. What do you mean it's happened in 18 seconds?
Well, that's because it's all, like, you have all this thing happening at once. The way I picture it is, the initiative is just for the help the players.
Yeah,
have an
much.
Order to combat. And who happens to be faster than the foe. Other
pretty
than that,
much,
I figure it happens about all around about the same time. And that's how come it fits in a whole of 6 seconds.
Pretty much, actually.
Okay.
Believe me, a lot can happen in 6 seconds.
Mm-hmm.
This is true. Okay, 1 second here, pulling up my reference.
We are Siamese, please.
Ba-dum-bum-bum.
We are Siamese if you don't,
please.
That's the ballad of our cats.
Yeah, pretty much.
You mean almost all cats?
Our cats are actually about half Siamese.
All cats are Sith.
No, I believe that. Okay. Yes. Okay. Ruville, what's your dex?
16.
Nice. Okay. Roll your spellcraft.
Spellcraft?
Yep. Okay, you see a guy who is clearly some kind of priest come out and begin chanting something which looks suspiciously like it might be. I don't know, how specific can this get at that score, I wonder?
Specifically.
Specific?
I know what spell he's got.
Yep, he is about to call down a flame strike.
Son of a bitch.
You are the only one who can act before he does. What do you do?
How far away is he from me?
Good question. How far away do you have to be to cast this fucking thing?
Flame strike?
It's 10-foot radius.
Yeah, but how the range?
That's the attack.
Yeah, the range is relevant, right? So.
All right, range is close, I believe.
Okay, medium. So he's roughly 100 feet away.
Damn, too far.
Okay, charge him.
You can charge 100 feet in a round?
Yeah, I can charge 120 feet.
Okay.
He has a speed spell on him, I'm guessing, of some sort.
Nope, 60-foot movement rate on the...
Yep, that's true. So double movement is 120. Correct. Okay.
Charge him and run him through.
All right. Roll the hit.
I rolled natural 20.
Are you serious? Do I have to come out and look at this?
Sable. Nah. No. He's making up for last week when he kept rolling ones.
That's true. He had a bad day last week. That is a fact. Okay. Confirm critical?
Confirm critical is a 16 on the die, so like 32.
Yeah, okay.
Something like that.
Shake my head. All right, roll damage. Players ruin my perfectly good bad guy. Damn you. Okay.
Well, he might not kill him, but it's only stop any spell.
Oh, almost certainly the spell's going to fizzle, yes.
I guess Flame Strike is one of those round one round spells.
Although he could make it, he could, you know, hit a natural 20 on his concentration check, man.
Yeah.
That's true.
He could.
Hey. Surprise opening, double damage, and one free attack against the target with a minus 5 penalty.
Okay.
Sheepers. For the crit.
I made sure to roll the damage. Hmm.
This dice is... Hey, wait. That's Arian, not Rovell.
So I did 40 points of damage.
Hmm. Okay.
And my attack with a minus 5 penalty is 24.
Yes, that still hits.
Is he gonna one round the
He might.
Cleric?
He might.
I forgot to smite evil on him.
Well, you might want to do it now.
Too late.
Mm-hmm. You have to. I believe smite evil is one of those things you have to declare before you
declare
attack.
Declare before you attack. Mm-hmm. Yeah. All right, and I did 12 points damage on that one.
So no, you did not kill him, but his spell does kind of fizzle. Yes.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Well, Haley. Damn it.
At least I'm not going to say anything because it might give you ideas.
It might. Yes, you should keep your mouth shut.
This is the place where you should be being quiet.
Mm-hmm.
I'll wait till after the
At least you know what's
fight.
Good for you. Of course, Ruvel is by himself now, surrounded by a bunch of people that are with the priest.
Yep.
Madrimlian, your go.
Well, are they still in a military formation?
No,
the formation has completely collapsed in the front. This new group coming out has not yet formed their formation. These are the tougher dudes, but they just got here.
Right. So I'm going to find me a nice look for 30 feet down where I can get as many idiots as I can. And I'm going to psionic blast them.
Okay.
Preferably in Ruvel's wake.
Roll a d6.
D6, mm-hmm. Right.
I am eating chocolate cranberries. They are good.
They would be good.
They are very good.
You have chocolate snozzberries?
Mm-hmm.
5.
Okay, you can get 5 of them at once.
Okay. So yeah, I'm going to sonic blast them, and I'm going to spend 4... I'm going to... That's what I'm looking for. Augment it by 4 power points. So they do get a DC. A will DC, but it's a difficulty 20.
Okay.
And any who fail their roll are stunned for 3 rounds.
Okay. I'll save you some, Eli. Eli wants some of my chocolate. I don't blame Eli. I would want some of my chocolate, too. Chocolate is good.
Yes, chocolate is good.
All right. One of them did actually roll a 20. And one of them rolled a 1.
One of them rolled a 20. Dang it, we can't counter that one.
Nope. Oh, yes. And for those of you new to the game as well, there is, I think it's relatively cheap. Like, 1,000 points gives you a reroll. You can choose. It'll, one action may have a reroll used on it up to twice, period. Right? You can use it for or against the players as you like, or for or against the DM as you like. But you cannot reroll ones or twenties. What's up?
You said chocolate covered
crap. Do you see this? Do you see this?
Yeah. Yes. Yes.
All right. Go help yourself, hon. I will come into the room and be on Sable's camera in order to have chocolate cranberries. Well, that's fair. I understand. No, no, that is Siobhan. I live at Siobhan's house right now. That was who walked in. That was Siobhan. Yeah. And she wanted chocolate, which I understand.
I am regretting I did not make popcorn.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
And see, you did not see her face because she is taller than my camera. So. And I am short.
And she is wearing a mask.
Yep, that's true. And Gala is like, I is a Sable kid, except I can't just show up on cam and be like chocolate cranberries, exactly. Alright. Okay, so yes, one of them failed catastrophically.
Yes, Gala is one of ours.
Mm-hmm. No, one of them failed catastrophically and the other one succeeded spectacularly. So what the hell happens now? I forgot.
I believe it was just a stun, yeah.
Right, stun for three rounds.
Guy who rolled a one is probably unconscious.
Hey, do we have, like, a psionic crit or fail?
Magic, it works the same.
No, do it. Let's see what happens.
Okay. Oh,
that's okay there, Fox. I understand that. Fox says
magic. Normal damage and the target is charmed for three rounds. Will negates.
What the?
You hit him right in the love button.
Instead of stunning him, he falls in love with you and starts attacking on everyone else, I guess.
That is one sexy elf.
Wow. I'm not even sure how to incorporate that. My goodness. Okay. All right.
Basically, he's stunned him and he loves him.
That's it's amazing. Like, remember when the cougar smacked George against the side of the house?
Yeah, exactly.
Well, fair enough. You are my sun, my moon, my starlit sky. Without you, I dwell in darkness.
Yep.
Now, for those of you who know what movie that came from, you get bonus nerd points.
I get bonus nerd points.
Mm-hmm. Well, this might be bonus old nerd points at this point.
Dad gets bonus old nerd points.
Correct!
Yeah.
Yes, that is the movie there, Daz. Correct. So you get to be, you get bonus nerd points.
Yeah, bonus nerd points for Daz.
Awesome. Okay. So yeah. We also had a, like, you know, critical success of, like, the guy.
So a fumble?
Yeah.
Oh, wait.
That's right. Out of the way, Peck.
I fumble. Fumble. Apprentice move. Reroll the attack against the creature nearest to the target, yourself excluded. You got somebody closest to him in the attack.
So, Ruvel?
Yeah, probably.
Yeah, probably.
He's like the only one there.
Okay, roll will to negate being stunned for 3 20? Rounds. Yep, that's the same difficulty everybody else had.
Yeah, I rolled like 29 or something.
Okay, so yeah, you felt that psionic wave wash over you. You're like, what the fuck, man?
Nah, I know that collateral damage happens in war.
Okay.
Jobs wasn't aiming for me.
A pretty good move, actually, that.
I just got in front of this fucking guy that he was aiming at.
Oh! Hey! You were doing that around Ruvel, right?
Yeah.
Madrimlian? Siobhan! What are you doing?
Yes, it was down following Ruvel because Ruvel's going to be too far away when he hits the guy because it's only a 30 foot. You said Ruvel was 100 feet.
120.
Yep, that's true. Okay, so unfortunately it isn't close enough to actually hit the priest, is it?
Nope.
No.
Okay. Alright, next attack is Arden.
Is anyone in melee with me right now? I don't think so.
No, I think you killed the last batch.
Okay. Mm-hmm. So I'm gonna... There's how many players again? Let me actually...
Remember, some of those group buff spells require people to be within a certain distance of each other.
Yep.
I know. That's why I probably can't get Ruvel. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4. Myself.
You can't get the ladies either.
Right. So 1, 2, 3, myself. So that's 4. I can target an extra 5 people.
The king?
The king. That's still another 4.
And some of the upper level troops that are near to you?
Sure, we'll do that. I'm casting haste.
Okay.
I'm aging! Aging!
Haste doesn't do that in this edition.
Furthermore, you're an elf. No. Oh, I aged 6 months. Age what year. The? Oh, wow. Boo!
I now have a spot on my nose. Thanks for the acne.
Yeah,
elven blemishes take forever to get rid of, however.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, because elves live so long, their acne phase lasts longer. Anyways, yeah. So, cast haste. So that means everyone gets to, let me see, one extra attack with you. As well, if the attack is made using your full attack bonuses, you get plus one bonus to attack rolls, plus one bonus to dodge AC bonus, and plus one bonus to reflex saves.
Handy all around.
And you get your movement speed, all types of movement is increased by 30 feet as well.
Awesome. All right, Arian, your goal.
Sorry, I was muted. Nobody's in melee range, and everyone's about 100 feet away, you said?
There are two orcs that are injured within the vicinity of you, but they're, like, I don't remember who was in melee with whom. I'm pretty sure Arden killed the last batch. I think, based on this amount of damage, it can't have been you either, because they've been, you know, scratched. So...
I if I recall, the turn after this, before this one, I cast a fireball.
Right.
And roasted an entire squadron.
Yeah.
So, I guess I will just hold my action to attack the first enemy who comes into melee range.
Okay, basically you guys are leaving Ruvel out there to twist in the wind. Is this what I'm hearing?
Well, my job's to stand in front of the king in my big form for another five rounds, so...
Okay.
Everybody else can go help Ruvel, but my job's to be the blocking shield.
Gotcha.
I was trying.
Yeah, Majulian tried to help. I was gonna do the buff everyone anyways. He just ran out of my way before I could buff him.
All right. Xerxes.
Xerxes is going to magic missile this priest.
Okay.
Is he in darkness?
Yeah, magic missile the darkness.
Yep.
Let me see here.
Hello, darkness, my old friend.
Can I have some Mountain Dew?
Twenty points of damage.
Yeah.
You rolled pretty high on those D4s.
Blammo.
Yep. I averaged 3.
Well, this priest is having a bad day.
He wishes his god had told him to stay home in bed.
Yep,
he's... Are you kidding me? Gromash would not do that.
He is not at all having a good day. Let's see here. I'm deciding what the king is doing.
He is not playing the skin flute.
Where the fuck did that come from?
I have not even had any red food dye today.
Uh-oh.
So there's no really good reason for it.
Okay.
The dog has commandeered my pillows.
Typical of her.
What's that?
That's typical of her.
Yeah. Well, like, you need them while you're gaming anyway.
Yeah. Oh, she's cute.
She's just making sure that you stay awake.
Yeah.
No nap for you.
She'll take the nap for me.
Okay, let's see here. Okay, so... Yeah. All right, so a bunch of black tentacles erupt out of the ground near to where Ruavel is and starts grabbing the soldiers, the priest, and every fucking thing in sight. Yep. What am I rolling against here to attack you with the tentacles? Because, I mean...
reflex save.
Yeah, okay, make a...
reflex save?
I guess so, yeah.
I rolled 22.
Okay. You go, ooh, shit, and manage to dodge out of the way of the tentacles. Oh, there, that guy's having a good day.
He goes running down, returning blasphemy, he's like, yowza, and jumps over the tentacle. Whoa, what the heck?
I mean, magical combat can be pretty insane, you know?
Oh, yeah.
Should play the Benny Hill theme, you know?
Yep.
No, that's...
Or bring in the drums.
That'll be my mother, right on cue, phoning. Yeah.
Hello? I'm okay.
Mute.
I don't know. I'll phone you. Okay. Maybe. Okay. Okay, bye-bye. She's just touching base with me about taking her out tomorrow.
Ah, okay. Yeah, please don't call the darkness up, says Dragon Magpie. I already have to deal with the hunger of the void incarnate on a regular basis. He picks me up like a gerbil. Yeah. Does as like the void tells you, and I will love you and squeeze you and call you George. Yeah, all right, so you managed to dodge the tentacles coming out of the ground. So do a bunch of other people. Not the priest, though. He's grappled.
Good. Gave his fucking head in.
Yeah, that's what Xerxes is doing, caving his fucking head in. Oh, Xerxes shot him already.
Xerxes already shot him.
All right, so then...
It's an attack of opportunity.
Right. Actually, that's true. Okay, go ahead, take it.
Okay. All right. So, 19 on the die.
Okay, yep.
So that's like 33?
Yep.
And the threat?
Yep.
And 27 to confirm.
Yeah, definitely confirms. Let's see what the Phone of Doom says.
Okay, Doom.
By the way, there's these apps called iCrit and iFumble, and I used to have them on my phone, then I replaced my phone, but Aaron still has them on his phone, so he is rolling those.
iCrit. Bam, muscle wound, double damage and 1d2 strength damage.
Ew, that's gonna suck.
Damage.
Yeah, and...
And 2 strength.
And goodbye. That's it for him.
Bam, gave his head in.
You did indeed.
Fucker.
Throwing flame strikes at people?
Yep.
How dare!
No flame strikey for you. No barbecue for me.
That's clippable, man. That's good.
Except Rowan, you don't have to worry about it. It's barbecue for me.
Yeah, depending. I like this conversation. Daz is like, priest wants to die and rise up as a lich. I mean, lich. Right? Dragon Magpie says, to be honest, a lick would be scarier. Depends on from what. Yeah, if that mass of tentacles starts licking you, I'd be a little concerned, too. That would be a problem. Okay. It's Crowley's turn.
Crowley's turn. Alright, does Rubel look like he's in a deep or what? Like, he needs help or?
Well, he is kind of all by himself in the middle of a bunch of enemies. Now, fortunately, there are like tentacles grabbing the enemies, but they don't look like they're avoiding him either, you know?
Okay, so basically...
Lem, yeah, exactly.
A writhing mass of tentacles grabbing at everything.
Yep.
Okay. Well, I guess I'm going to bound in and try and jump onto the back of the first guy that's in front of me or onto his chest and start clawing at his eyes.
Nice! Okay. So this is a charge, then, because... And what's your movement rate normally? Oh, wait a minute. You're hasted currently, aren't you?
Yeah. Doesn't need to be a charge because of
the
haste.
You're right. He doesn't need to charge because he's hasted. He just goes zoop. All right, roll your attack. Hey, Bob. Welcome. Good to see you. He said he would probably stop by tonight. I was in his stream this morning.
Dino Bobasaurus Bob is finally here.
Daily thing? No, I already used that. But then, do you want me to roll a acrobatics check to see if I land on his chest first?
Sure, that makes sense.
Okay. Yeah, acrobatics would allow him to avoid any attacks of opportunity from moving.
Mm-hmm.
It's true.
18.
Nice. Yeah, no trouble. He just kind of, you know, tumbles in there like a scary little ball of fur. This probably is kind of your nightmare about cats. If you don't, you know, because you hear this, right? And then all of a sudden there's claws everywhere. Roll the hit.
So, one I know missed because I rolled a 4.
Roll it.
Don't forget, people can re-roll for him.
Okay. Yeah, I'll re-roll for him.
Oh, okay.
And fight ensues over who gets to do the re-roll.
Bob got it. Got it. Thanks, Bob. And Aaron is storing one up.
I'm loaded.
Oh, my.
I hear, oh, my God, in the background. This could be interesting.
Yeah. So one natural one.
Oh, that does not get chanced.
Yeah. You're stuck with that one. Yeah.
That was my bite attack.
Okay.
I went for a claw bite.
Uh-huh.
So one was a 4, which I re-rolled and it became a 3. And one was
re-roll that one again.
Okay.
No more re-rolls for Collie.
Okay. Well, the claw worked, and then the bite was a major.
Yeah,
you get a rage attack. A rake.
Okay.
You can rake with your back legs.
It does seem fitting for the fight scene. You guys didn't hear, but
side of his face, and then kick off of his face with my back claws.
Yeah.
Well, yeah, I'm pulling my claws towards the front to rip his cheeks open.
Yeah, that's
like doing a backflip off of the guy while raking my claws from behind his ears up through his chin.
Yeah.
Okay, and my back claws going into the, you know, facial area. Oh, we still got to deal with that fumble.
Yep.
Yeah.
Okay, then you bite your tail.
Natural. Natural. Bam. You caught your fucking lip on something. You take 1d6 points of bleed.
Ouch.
You're bleeding.
Okay. Hey, Joe, have you got a pencil?
Okay, I'm trying something, guys. Be prepared for stream borkage.
Okay, roll a d6 there, Blake.
Okay, give me one sec. 2.
Okay, you take 2 points of bleed. That means you're losing 2 hit points around. Until somebody does first aid on you, basically.
Ouch. That sucks.
Well, we're supposed to make a little catnip.
Or like bite.
We already dealt with that once.
Okay, now for the damage of my claw attack.
Well, that did nothing, so. Ah, hey, Travis, welcome. Thank you so much for the raid. Good to see you.
Raid from Travis, thank you.
If you're not familiar with Travis, he's an awesome writer, and you should check him out. He's relaxed, he's not afraid to swear, so, you know, this is fun.
And he smokes a pipe like me.
That's right.
Yep.
Which makes him automatically cool.
Okay, so I'm sorry. How much damage did we end up doing overall? We had a sound alert redemption 18 there.
18 points of damage.
18 points. Yikes. Okay, that's pretty good.
And you're...
I don't know what the break was.
It does double claw damage. You roll your claw damage twice and add strength and a half damage.
Okay. So roll it twice, you said?
Yeah. Roll like one each.
And half added to that.
No, just half your strength bonus.
Oh, okay. I don't have a strength bonus, so.
Oh, wait, yeah. So 26. All right. So there you go. 26 and 18, that's 42.
44?
26, 18, 44.
Points of damage? He's fucking dead. Bye!
Just ripped his face right off.
Good job, baby.
Yeah, like literally.
Flayed his face.
Flayed his face.
Why you don't cross? That's why you don't piss off a black cat.
Since it'll only take a second, I'll hold up the bloody chunk of skin that was his face and just at the other guys.
Yeah. Yeah, that's pretty intimidating. I think they might actually have to roll morale on that one. Fuck. Okay.
Make an intimidate check.
Yep, make an intimidate check.
How many hit dice do they have?
I don't know.
4 to 6?
Yeah, something like that.
21.
That's good enough to do it. Exactly what he needed to do a 6-hit die. Creature.
Okay.
That means they gotta make a will save at DC 21. Or be shaken.
Okay, yeah, so a bunch of them are like,
holy fuck, that cat's freaky. You had to look away from me.
Flaming priest.
Nobody wants to fight Crowley now.
Yep.
Go after the paladin. Save her.
Not for long.
Paladin with a 22 charisma.
Oh yeah, just fucking smite some. You can just
smite makes them. Right.
Smite makes right, and I get +6 to all my fucking saves.
Okay. Okay, and at this point, a whole bunch of shit is about to happen all at once. For one thing, I'm tired of not having, like, half the party at the battle, so I'm going to create shit for them. Secondly, the chat crew is getting bored, and I want to give them something to do. And third, you know, things are going to get interesting. So, would this be a good time to take a brief break, do you think?
Yes, I believe so.
Sure.
Okay. Yeah.
Then go get more coffee.
John is very excited about you creating something for the other half of the party.
Okay, awesome. Yeah, I'm sure Dawn is bored to death by now. So, yes, and
I didn't really realize when we, you know, we tucked you guys all away that this was going to go this way. I kind of just didn't think about it. But
That's fair.
Not that I'm the storyteller, but I am sure that our storytellers are up to the creativity challenge that it presented.
Yep. Yeah, I just had to have a certain amount of time pass before realistically something could happen to them. I think it's past now. We can have something happen. So, okay. Sure. All right, we're going to take a brief break. Probably about the 10 minutes that it will say on the clock. Don't go anywhere. We'll be right back. Shit's about to get real.
And Aaron? Thank you.
Sable is still eating, but we figured that you guys were probably bored of listening to the same song over and over. I will be just a moment.
Isn't this the part where we're supposed to get deep shots by Crowley?
Yeah.
I think Crowley is still somewhere else.
Probably having a joint.
Good.
Ah, so it's not just me, okay.
Yeah. So Dragon Magpie is going to come up here and marry us so that she can cook for us.
Yay! Actually, awesome. Immigration to Canada is more complicated than just a marriage. That just gives you points to immigrate.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It makes no guarantees on the topic. Nope, unlike some other general places.
Yeah, she's outside of Sable's store. I can hear her now.
Sable is not sharing her pork chop.
No.
Good on you, Fox Rider. 5,000 words today. Huzzah.
Nice.
Banshee Hush.
Some of them are even useful.
Yeah, like Jan Stretch says, getting married to somebody who's British and you're pretty much guaranteed citizenship in England.
Bob, that sounds like Black Dragon cuisine.
That's ogre kimchi.
I think it took Helene of our friends, Helene and Peggy, like 2 years for them to get Helene citizenship after they got married.
Yeah. No, actually, she got her citizenship first. Right, then they got married. She wanted to do it independently. Right. But it took them like 14 years or something to get her citizenship.
Bob, that was probably Weirdowin who suggested that.
Fox Trainer. That's right. Today sucks. Screw this. And there's rain done for the day. It was supposed to Eli.
Yeah, that is definitely not how I make kimchi. Although Chris will probably claim that it smells like something that had to happen to while it's fermenting. Fortunately, his mom likes it pretty mild, so it has like 3 days and then it goes in the fridge with a lid.
Aww.
Kimchi is awesome.
Don will be along momentarily.
Okay. And we'll need deep thoughts from Crowley.
Right.
Some deep thoughts with Crowley. Well, we've definitely gotten ourselves into a pickle now. I'm thinking my alliance with the Dragon Syndicate is a smart move for me.
Yes, it was.
And it's always something for me to pull back on. Not to speak for the rest of the crew, because, well, much as I love them, if I have to part ways, we have to part ways. But it won't be now. Oh, just deep thoughts with Crowley. Inside Crowley's mind. Oh. And that was another deep thoughts with Crowley.
Right. Madrillon's going to kick your ass later, no?
Madrillon's going to get his ass kicked by Crowley later.
Yes, that's perhaps more likely.
Cal Crowley laid the smack if down on you.
I unfortunately missed deep thoughts with Crowley because I was in the other room.
Crowley was thinking about the fact that he made a good choice in getting an alliance with the Dragon Syndicate.
Uh-huh.
Can you imagine having goblins in this fight too?
Uh-huh. All right. So... Let's see. I think first thing that's going to happen is, as the rest of you are booting away from the combat zone, a big fucking rock of shit comes crashing down. Boom! And hits the ship. Everybody make a reflex save. That's all the female characters currently.
A reflex save? Yeah.
I actually get to take my dice out tonight. I didn't think I was going to. Oh.
I rolled a natural one.
Oh!
Ouch.
Well, that could be the end of...
Dirty 20.
Oh, that could be interesting.
Combo.
Yep. This is crash damage. I don't know how you'd run that.
Would you run it as ranged, natural, or magic?
It's not magical.
So ranged?
Sure.
Okay.
Or perhaps bludgeoning.
Bludgeoning critical, right? That's what we'll do. Bludgeoning critical, skull crush, double damage, and 2d6 intelligence drain, fortitude for half.
Yikes!
What am I rolling?
Fortitude save. Don't roll another one.
Yeah.
Please.
A d20?
Yes.
Yeah.
D20.
Pick a different d20, Blake says. Okay.
And drain is permanent unless magically restored, right?
Yep.
I rolled a 3. What am I adding to it?
Reroll that.
Okay.
I'll load a reroll in case she needs another one.
I rolled an 8.
It's a restoration spell, I believe.
Reroll that? Oh my goodness. I'm not having the luck today.
Yeah, greater restoration, actually.
I rolled a 3.
They're
out of rerolls, aren't they?
Yep.
Okay, so I rolled a 3. Now, what am I adding to it?
It's not enough. You add your fortitude save bonus.
Your fort.
So that's a 9.
Nice 12.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Not enough.
Nope.
So am I dead?
No.
No.
Just really hurts. I'm
gonna wish you were, though.
You're dumb.
I'm just dumb.
Okay. Compete worse than death.
So, how much damage did you take, babe?
Yeah, that's a good question. Now, what,
10d6 would seem apropos.
10d6, okay. Yeah, I guess. I was going to do 5d6, but all right.
Oh, it's doubled and becomes 20d6?
Yikes.
Yep.
Is it 20d6?
Yep.
Are you fucking shitting me?
That's not, no. That can't be right.
No, that's right.
It was fired from space.
They hit her with an asteroid.
Well, oops, if I killed somebody. Sorry. It wasn't intended. But, hey, them's the breaks. We're player characters, right?
Yep.
I don't know how I like it about a player dying to, like, basically a meteor.
Yeah, like, stupid shit.
A random save like that, yeah.
I'm really not fond of characters dying from stupid shit either. You know, character sacrifices themselves in heroic stand, you know.
Yeah.
Character, you know, it is an idiot and fights until they die, you know. Fine, right? Stupid shit random, you know, it's realistic.
Got a lot of hit points, so.
The genre's called fantasy. It's meant to be unrealistic, you myopic manatee. Right? So, yeah.
Well, here's the thing to consider.
We have access to resurrection spells and such.
We do.
Resurrection, reincarnation.
Oh, reincarnation could be fun, though.
Of course, that is interesting because I believe that elven laws say that succession changes if you die.
Yep.
So that's interesting.
So who's next? Vonvin?
No,
Celine. No, actually, I think Vonvin is the youngest.
Vonvin was the youngest.
Yep.
All right, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. All right.
Don't the rings have like a contingent word of recall on them that takes the dead body of one of the princesses directly back to the Imperial High Chapel?
That is exactly what happens. Yep. But let's see if she survives this first. I wouldn't bet on it with it being 20d6.
I can't remember if Pathfinder. If Pathfinder, if you hit 0, you're unconscious or you're dead.
You're unconscious. In Pathfinder, you can go to a negative equal to your constitution rating.
And even if that weren't the case in Pathfinder, we tend to play that way. Mm-hmm. So. All right. The first batch of d6s: 10, 20, 30. Yeah, that would be 40 points even.
How?
Second round of d6s. And this is 10d6 I am rolling at a time, by the way. I had to get them all out! Well, not all of them, actually, but most of them. Alright.
All the shiny math rocks.
Math rocks! Math rocks! Okay. That would be, 4 times 6 is 24, 34, this is added to the previous total, 35, 40, 44, so we have 84 points of damage.
Blammo! Well, that would have knocked me out, and I have 81 hit points.
Well, I have 114 hit points.
Yep, she survived it.
That you actually probably wanted to not.
Yeah.
Yeah, probably. But
much intelligence does she lose?
Yeah, who's rolling 2d6? Dawn?
Dawn is,
Yeah, these are the dice of doom, right?
Yes.
Yep.
Do I want a high number or a low number?
Low.
Low.
Okay, one.
You want snake eyes.
For fuck's sakes. 10.
You lose 10 points of intelligence.
Re-intelligence.
My re-intelligence.
Wow.
You're basically in a state that you can run around in circles and giggle to yourself.
Oh my god.
But you survive, which means you're still the air.
Can this get healed away at some point?
Yes.
There
is a way.
Yes.
Okay.
As a matter of fact,
with the loss of some mental faculties, she immediately teleports away.
Okay.
As soon as her mental faculties go.
All right, so all of you who are present, roll a spot check, right, to notice that?
Yeah.
That she's been teleported away in the middle of the fucking insanity of the ship blowing up around you.
Oh, so that's just the women again, or is that the entire party?
That is the ladies again, yes, of the party.
Have a good night, Fox Rider.
Good night, Fox. Thanks for joining us. If you want, you can always catch the rest of the VOD tomorrow. And it's been fun having you. I hope you had a good time.
Okay, it isn't great of restoration. It's just normal restoration. Gets rid of it. But it does require diamond dust worth 100 GP to cure. It's only 1,000 GP if you're dealing with negative levels.
Yep.
How'd we do on our spot checks?
Rowan?
I've got a 16 on the die. I'm just trying to find...
Perception. Under P.
Which is after
16 plus 11 is...
27.
Okay, now make your own reflex saves if you haven't yet. Remember, you're in this crash, too.
18, 19,
20, 21, 22. Yeah, I think the DC for this is 20. It's hard. You're in the middle of a crash. But you made it, which means half damage.
Which is 42 points.
Yes.
Nope.
Oh, wait, no. 42 would be normal damage. So
21.
21
points.
All right.
Now, roll a d6, please, and tell me which number you get.
Just a second here.
So I should be rolling this.
I got a math here. 58
minus 22 is...
Okay. All right, so basically the world kind of just blows up. You didn't even see it coming. All of a sudden it was momentarily dark. Celine had time to get out. Oh, and then everything went to hell. Boom. Dawn, I also need you to roll a d6 and tell me what you get.
Okay. 1.
Okay. And then there's a flash, because I imagine there's a massive flash, right? When she teleports out.
Yep.
Mm-hmm.
All right. Yeah, okay, so you guys land, crashed all around. The ship basically breaks into two pieces. Some of it starts on fire. Most of it just kind of turns into splinters.
Yep. And was the king on board?
Yeah. Actually, I forgot to roll his reflex save, didn't I? Okay.
As far as we know.
Mm-hmm.
Well, that'll be one way to find out he's not the king, all right?
Or it's one way that we find out he was the king.
Oh, God, Sable would totally do that, wouldn't she?
Yes, I would. Yes, I would. You know I would. But, no.
You don't think his general would have talked him into leaving? Mm-hmm. If he's going to take his place?
Well, let's face it, the way it's going to turn out is wherever the king ends up dying is where he actually is.
Yep.
Okay. I have a question.
Yes.
So what happened to all of you guys being in the hutch for safety?
Plot happened.
That's true. Oh. That was the thing. Wasn't it?
That was. So
instead, what happens is we get smashed around inside the hutch for that much damage as it tumbles and rolls. Nobody is scattered in four directions. Dawn still gets seriously injured and disappears. But we see it because we have only the hutch that we're in.
Yep.
It kind of lands on its side. So, like, the roof is the wall. Celine kind of staggers to her feet. She says, status report.
I'm okay, says London. Yasma teleported somewhere.
That means she was probably seriously hurt and was teleported to Dad. Dad, is she okay?
Really?
Just remember, she has to
concentrate on what you need to do. Concentrate on what you need to do right now.
Okay. Okay, Dad says he's got it. Worry about what we're doing.
Best guess is the ship that we were on is under attack.
Somebody roll me a luck roll.
I think that's Von Vin's job.
Okay.
Yeah, just tell me what die you're rolling and what you get.
D25.
You got a 5. The door is re-roll now on that. The ground. Oh, he had re-roll a reroll that. Stored up, so he can do that.
Yeah.
All right. That's a 16 now.
The what was formerly the door is now the north-facing wall. You can get out without killing yourselves. You don't have to, like, climb up to the door to get out. Neither is it on the ground.
Peer out the keyhole.
You see sky. Oh, wait, no, you're looking out the north-facing window. You see part of... What do you see? It might have been the bow of the ship is stuck in a tree.
Well, she says, I have good news and bad news.
Okay.
The bad news is the ship is definitely dead. The good news is it didn't die in the water, so we should actually be able to disembark onto dry ground.
Oh, that's good to know. Okay, she says. All right, let's get out of here. Cautious egress, she says. Everybody suit up if you're not already. Eli, rerolls only last the session. Is the answer to that question. So yes, you can, but if it is not used by 9 o'clock when we call it, it's lost.
We clear the queue.
But yes, you can buy it ahead of time. That's fine. Okay, so Eli's holding onto a reroll. And Aaron spent his, but I think there's still another reroll stored currently that hasn't been used yet. Magpies and Siobhan's. Yeah. They both have a reroll stored. Okay.
Daz says the rescue rabblers are ready, Captain.
Yes. Yes, emergency evac. Let's get them down here, she says.
Yeah. Xerxes orders the chat crew to go and see to the down ship.
Xerxes cannot do that because Xerxes is fighting on the ground, but Alessander will.
Okay.
Remember, he was left in charge. Yep. Mm-hmm. So, chat crew to the rescue! Pew! See, I told you I'd give you guys both something to do. In the meantime, the fight wages on the other battlefield.
Mm-hmm.
Dun, dun, dun. Ruvel.
Ruvel is clearing out of this area. Right? There's big tentacles fucking grabbing everybody in this area, so I'm flying up at least 10 feet out of the range of the tentacles. Taking a quick surveil of the area. See what looks like the most dangerous opponent on the field.
Okay, there are a number of people who look considerably better trained. They have some ogres with them, mm-hmm. right, who are disembarking from the ships that have just landed, right, and forming into lines.
Ogres, eh? Ogres forming into lines?
There's several people. There are some who are forming into lines. They look like crossbowmen. Behind them, there are ogres. And they are coming out with people who might very well be some kind of priest.
Okay. All right. Well, that's where the moon directs me to go. So I'm going after those priests.
Okay.
Might makes right.
That works. Of course, you do realize you're going to have to get through the crossbowmen and the ogres to get to the priests, right?
I can go over them.
Okay, I guess
crossbow
I better...
might see them.
Our chat crew is like ready and eager to help, so I guess I better give them a clear picture of what happened. You guys are actually on the Void Chaser, and the Void Chaser is fine. It's been lurking in an asteroid's shadow waiting for an opportunity to rescue people if need be. It's the bug suit guys who have been asked to go, right? However, I do believe Alessander would have been made aware of Bosun Oleander's true mission.
Mm-hmm.
So he will lend you his bug suit. It says suit up. There's nothing immediately on fire where the rest of the chat crew is, because it was the bug suit guys who were told to go, right? Not
yep.
the rest of the ship? Okay. Don't worry. No. I'll give you guys something to do in a minute, too. I got plans. It's okay. Right? And the rest of you who are not in a bug suit, you are told to hold position, right? Remain at your stations. But you are aware that there's been some serious problems that have happened to most of your officers that would spread through the ship like wildfire. So shit is tense. Also, the fleet is all around you. Yeah, so it is rescue rabblers and one extra. Yeah, okay, so I'm sorry. You were heading for the priest. You have to go through these guys to get there. Are you going to do that, or are you going to do something else?
I'm going to go over them.
Okay, so that's an acrobatics check, I believe.
Okay.
They get an attack of opportunity, I believe.
Unless I make my acrobatics check.
That's true. Okay, roll it.
I rolled a natural 20.
Jesus Christ.
I honestly don't think you... Jesus Christ particularly cares what Aaron does and does not roll on his dice.
Yep.
I said the saving throw. He might care that because Jesus saves.
Yeah, Jesus saves. But Judas scores on the rebound. You can't reroll natural 20s, Bob.
Or natural 1s. You're stuck with them. We've changed the rule that way.
Yeah.
Look, I believe him because he'd laugh and if he got like a 2.
Yep. Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
It's like fucking... Chris says there, my plus six to saves won't help me when it counts all roll a one. You know? My dice hate me that way.
You know what? It's a total side thing here. We started out with 799 followers. 800 is where we get our next giveaway. Now we have 798 followers, and I find myself wondering if Fox accidentally unsubscribed. Because they were going through and, like, flushing streams.
Yeah.
Or somebody's subscription just timed out and they haven't renewed it yet.
Well, this is followers, yeah. Not subscriptions.
Oh, yeah.
Exactly, absolutely. So, yeah.
Yeah, then it's possible because Fox did say that they were cleaning their,
You know what? I'll message them. But anyway.
Looking for 800 followers, so. And then we do a giveaway. At 800, that's pretty big.
Yeah, that's not bad at all. Can't complain. You guys are, I really appreciate your support, guys. Okay, so did you make, you rolled a natural 20 for your acrobatics check, so you kind of, you know, yep. Do this, like, beautiful flip. Jump right over the archers.
Smite makes right.
And smite makes right.
Bury my sword into the forehead of this fucking priest. All right, here I go. Here I go again on my own. Going down.
Did you really?
Yeah.
Oh, of course you did.
Of course I did.
Okay, that I'm looking at. I'll be right back.
Oh. Coming?
Banshee was on her way.
No, Banshee's upstairs.
When it counts, Ruvel comes to the rescue.
Fumbleya? Fumbleruski?
Fumbleya. Fumbleruski.
Pictures.
That's one. Yep. Hey, melee fumble.
Sorry,
says,
I had my main mic muted. That was a one.
Winded. You are exhausted. Fortitude negates.
That actually kind of makes sense.
Yeah, did a acrobatic thing. You're like, whoa, get. Let's fucking get my back for the thing there. I don't know. Let me think. Yeah, I should negate 22.
Yeah, negate.
Yeah.
Still a little breathless, though, I imagine.
Yeah. And I missed, of course.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And you so can't believe you just did that shit.
Murrow's reeling in front of the orc. He holds up his hands to go, wait a minute. Ooh, lightheaded.
Hi, Realm. Good to see you. I see you reroll. Yes, you cannot reroll ones or twenties anymore. But duly noted. Yeah. Magpie and Siobhan also have rerolls stored. Okay.
Magpie and I used our rerolls on Dawn's her.
Oh, you
her
did?
Four,
okay,
three,
so then
three.
Only Realm has a reroll stored then at the moment.
And Eli.
Oh, yeah, and Eli. Okay. All right.
Yes, and Eli.
And Eli. Okay, duly noted. Looks like they might need it tonight. Oh, yeah, and Bob, sorry. Bob spent one and didn't use it, so. Okay. All right, so. Yes, you missed. Does that mean they get an attack of opportunity on you?
No.
Okay. Moving on, I believe the next guy on our list is Madrimlian.
Ah, yes, the madman.
Mm-hmm. Well, Lieutenant Mad.
Madman Englishman.
Here's where he's going to earn his name. Because he's about to charge into the battle. Badly. And hit an area of effect with the stun. As soon as I can remember which one that is.
Sonic Blast.
No, that's what I just did. I got another one. I think it's the Eagle Whip.
Remind me of the stuff from last session.
Eagle Whip does charisma damage.
Yeah, I'm sure that she means the rescue rabblers. Yep.
No, it's the mental disruption. That's what I was looking for.
Right, Quill and Nimelin were keeping track of the movements.
Yeah, I would give them a bonus on staying out of sight with that, babe.
That does make sense. Okay, guys, rescue rabblers make stealth checks. You have a bonus. I won't tell you how much.
Yeah, I'm still going to psychic blast them for another thing. So, DC 20... and stun for 3 rounds if they fail. And I'm heading in to try and hit the big guys.
Okay. Stretch, you do not have time to do that if you are suiting up with the bug suit and heading down to the planet with them. Nineteen on the die for Stretch, duly noted. 18 total for Daz. Okay. Okay, I'm sorry. What are you doing again there, Siobhan?
Charging up 30 feet away from the fucking ogres and the sonic blasting.
Okay. Yep, that's fine, Stretch. Perfect. Gets other crew to do it then. Duly noted. Okay, so make your roll.
It's a save.
Oh.
DC 20.
Yeah, no, didn't save.
And it's a
area effect.
Yep.
Oh, okay, I gotta roll a bunch of people.
Probably get 2, maybe 3 of them. They take a 10-foot area,
so. Okay, so one catastrophically failed, one laughed at you like you're a complete, dust mote, and everybody else was kind of like, ah! So, yeah.
The guy that laughed at her points at his tinfoil hat.
Yep. Okay, unexpected blast. The spell affects all targets within 30 feet of you. You are immune to this effect. So it affects all targets within 30 feet of that ogre.
Right.
Right. So probably got about a dozen more because of that ogre fumbling.
That's probably true. But one ogre was like, "You are puny!
You are puny, and I have tinfoil hat."
Ah, but he's within 30 feet of that ogre who fumbled, so now he's going to make another roll.
No. Thanks once.
Nice try!
I have to try.
Yes, I remember that Daz always wears the tinfoil hat under the helm. Yep, I remember.
I will make my roll for Ruavel.
Yep.
He's within 30 feet of them.
Yes, he is.
Fortunately, Ruavel rolled really good. I rolled 18 on the die, so.
That is fortunate.
Yeah.
Okay. Is anybody else going with Daz, Stretch, and who else made their roll? So far, those are the only ones who made rolls, and the rescue rabblers.
Moon isn't here to make the roll.
Okay.
And I thought that Nimlin was playing Rando Elf. When Rando goes on missions.
That's true. And yeah, Nimlin doesn't have a suit yet. We'll fix this after this whole thing is done, but... Yeah, Bob did have one, actually, I believe.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, the roll is stealth. Nimlin needs someone else to roll. So someone else in the chat who wants something to do is welcome to. No bonus, but Bob rolled a 19, duly noted. Daz rolled a 15 for Rando. Okay. Barbarossa, do you have a suit? I can't remember whether you had a bug suit.
No, he does not.
Okay. So you guys do manage to approach the... Okay, yep. 19 on the die for Nimlin. All right. So you guys managed to approach the planet, as far as you can tell, unseen. But there is a shitstorm of a battle going on around you. Like, there is crap everywhere. I probably should make you guys all make at least one reflex save, too. Yeah, I think I will. Everybody make at least one reflex save. That's the rescue rabblers.
Well, I was going to say everybody, but yeah.
I is gnome, not bug, says Barbarossa. Okay, yeah, so a bunch... What does this do again there, Siobhan?
It stuns them for 3 rounds.
Yep.
Okay. Yeah, duly noted. A bunch of them are, like, screwed up. What the shit was that, Rowan?
That's what they're doing. They're just sort of standing there making burbly noises.
Yeah. Rando got a 12. Bob got a 12. Okay. That sounds like ouchies to me. Does that sound like ouchies to you too? I think it does.
Yeah.
Oh my god. That is not a good damage roll for you. Would they survive 27 points of damage? I don't know.
Oh god.
No.
Not likely.
So,
not likely.
I don't think we're gonna do that, because that's not right.
It's random fucking debris flying around. I'd use about 2d6.
Okay. Yeah, maybe it's not 3d6. Fair. Alright, so take 9 points of damage, Bob and Rando. Yeah. They got binged with shit, or, you know, some random splinter pierced their hand. Ah, motherfucker!
Yeah.
They shot their hair.
Son of a bitch!
That was only if Sable or Daz got hit.
Daz is not a Dorish princess.
strangely, even the princesses are not princesses, really. Not in that way.
Right.
Vonvin counts as a druish princess.
That's true. Vonvin is a druish princess. So if your hair gets shot, you have to use that line. It's now required.
Okay.
And you
duly
do get
noted.
Plus 8 to attack.
What's that?
Awesome.
You do get plus 8 to attack.
Yeah, there we go. Shot. Yeah, that's right. I do not have stats for Rando. That's fine. You know what? Just because I feel like it, Rando, we're going to have Rando get killed. Why? Because that gives us one more bug suit to give to a player. That's why.
Yep.
Boom! Rando gets his, basically, a random piece
splinter
of rail.
The eye socket.
Yeah, splinter goes into the eye socket. Bam!
And he goes down. Rando, you are my only friend.
Alas, poor Rando. I knew him well.
Yes, trauma for Nimalin. Woohoo! Okay. Redeemed reroll!
Technically,
okay.
Magpie can do that.
Alright, I'll reroll his reflex save. And he lives!
Although it was close.
Yeah.
Glanced
off his helmet.
Yeah, his helmet goes flying, kring, off into space.
Shit.
No longer protected.
You stay.
Get him out of space pretty quickly.
Yeah, it's not a sealed unit anymore. Fortunately, it still counts as a star metal talisman, so he does carry his own gravity well and etheric membrane around with him regardless, but it is not a sealed system anymore, and it will only last for a little while.
Yep.
So he needs to either go back to the ship or land quickly.
And she.
Or go after his helmet. I believe the senior officer there is Stretch. What should he do? I mean, he's not an officer, but he's the warrant.
Yeah.
Puts Randall on the space skid. Am I close by to grab this helmet? No, it went careening off quickly. You can chase it. You guys do have, like, basically a starfaring engine on your back. Yes, the amulet does have a star, powered air thingy. Yeah, that's true.
No?
The skid does, rather. Yep. With a net 19 giving 24 for reflex save. Okay, I try and save Rando. All right. He goes after the helmet.
Yep.
You know what? That's fine. You can catch it. It just takes an extra round before you arrive to rescue, and you will have to make another reflex save. In the meantime, next on the list is Arian.
Anybody closed up with us yet?
No, but they are starting to level crossbows in your direction.
Okay, well, I still stay still and play meat shield.
Okay. All right, Barbarossa, that's totally fair. Good night. Thank you for joining us. You're awesome, too. You know what? Okay, no, at about this time, people will start closing up. It just occurred to me I had another plan here. So, yeah, okay. People are now moving into reach. You may attack.
Okay.
We have a Hail Hydrate, guys. Thank you, Hail Hydrate.
I have no hydrate ability.
Hail Hydrate.
Hail Hydrate.
Flancha.
I don't know what Storm Step does exactly. Do you have to have a storm to use it?
No.
Yes.
Does it? Is it? Oh. I thought it was just the fact that it was a lightning ability, and so they called it Storm Step because it sounded cool.
Yeah, well, it's basically a dimension door ability.
Technically, okay. We did a storm of shrapnel.
But fine. Okay, I'll let you use it. It means you'll forego the extra round to get there. You will still need to make another reflex save. But there will be a benefit. Turn myself into a lightning bolt. Okay, that's cool. Yeah, duly noted, Stretch. Just make the second reflex save. I won't penalize you an extra round to get there. Okay, Daz informs the captain she's coming in with the mini pole armed with poo jar ammo. Dirty 20 on the reflex, you make it. Arian is in range to attack.
Okay. So, let's see. 24 on the first to hit.
Okay. That hits.
The second one is only a 19.
Probably hits too.
Yeah.
All right, the third one's only a 14.
Nope.
And the fifth one is the fourth one is an 18.
Yes.
And I forgot I'm hasted. So my other one at my full is higher than the first one, but not a crit. So two normal hits with the...
Nope.
Sorry, three normal hits with the leaf blade and one with the thorny blade.
Two, four. Just remember, you're large.
Yeah, I know. Oh. This guy looks pretty tough.
Yep, he's pretty tough.
Yep. Eat all of them. Cool. 50.
Okay.
64 points of damage.
64 points of damage. Blammo. Toast. I think mooks are, you know, even if they're tough mooks are, you know, you do 64 points of damage in a round, you're dead.
Yeah, I just basically take them apart.
Yeah, basically. Zing! A bunch of blades go flying and a bunch of body parts go flying.
Yep.
Uh-huh. Oh, my.
All right.
Just a quick short thing. Storm Step is you really do just turn into a ball of electricity.
Neat.
And it serves like a dimension door. It's just that if something's between you and where you're going, they take damage.
Neat.
Lexi's going to use that when he charged the fucking mage.
All right. So the storm of crossbow bolts arrives.
Oh, boy.
I'm going to need some ACs, my friends.
Thirty-four
for Arden, okay? Miss.
20. Did he miss by 5?
Did he miss by less than 5? If he misses by less than 5, he hits one of his
mirror images.
No.
Okay.
Okay. Arian, AC.
Twenty-three.
Missed. Ruvel, AC.
24.
And of course he hits.
Yeah, of course he does.
Of course he does.
Don't forget, Ruvel's actually behind the crossbowman.
Yeah, that is a point.
Yeah, that is a point.
Well, I suppose that's why he hit, because he realized there was an enemy behind him, and he turned around and shot him at point-blank range before he could die.
Right.
Ruvel takes 6 points of damage.
Ouch.
Madrimlian, AC.
21.
And that'll hit. 4 points.
How many?
Four. 1, 2, 3, 4.
Okay.
All right, and a crossbow bolt strikes the king.
Yep.
And he starts foaming at the mouth and falls to the ground.
The poison dead.
Is any of his guards proficient in healing magic? They should be.
Yep, they go running over. You see the king's face transform.
Oh.
Yeah.
It's his general. Actually, no. Wait, no. Nope, never mind. I forgot. No, it really is a king. Sorry. His face doesn't transform. I forgot. I had things the other way around.
Yeah.
It doesn't transform as it should have.
It should have. That's right. Oh, Crowley, AC. I almost forgot.
14.
Did you add one to your that because you're hasted?
Alright, that means I'm at 35.
Crowley takes 1 point of damage.
No, he was at 25. Because he was at 24 last week.
Right.
Crazy.
Oh, yeah.
No, he misses. Yep. And Xerxes.
Xerxes, 24.
Wait.
And Xerxes takes 3 points of damage.
Okay.
Yep. The king hath fallen.
Xerxes is running for his father.
And he sure is. Muttering under his breath about stupid, stubborn old bastard, probably.
Yep. Yep.
Can the gentleman figure out which crossbow bolt hit the king? Like, which crossbowman hit the king?
It was one of three that were in a particular group. You're not sure which one of them.
Alright.
Chances are all the bolts are poisoned.
Then we would have all had made fortitude saves.
For those who got hit, yeah.
No, it must have been the ones that were aiming at the king.
Yeah.
Poison's expensive. Don't give it to, like, normal troops. Those guys are not normal.
Well, that's what I mean, is that, you know, three of them at him with a poisoned arrow just so that they guaranteed to hit.
Yep.
So how long do you think it takes these guys in the bug suits to get to the planet?
Couple of rounds.
Yeah, that's what I figured too. Okay. basically because they're dropping like rocks until the last minute. They're making halo dives.
Yep.
There is no noise because they are in space.
No, they're making sonic booms once they hit atmosphere.
Yeah. Oh god, yeah, as soon as they hit atmosphere, it's gonna be a loud boom. Or five.
It could be just all at one if they sync. It could be just one if they synchronize their entry.
And it's It'll not sound gonna matter because like nobody will hear it.
Yeah, it will sound more like Rolling Thunder. He's right. It is Xerxes' turn, by the way.
Okay, Xerxes is rushing over to his father.
Do you have medicine at all? Medic, anything like that?
No.
Okay.
Healing potion in his pocket, perhaps?
It's not going to do anything to... poison.
No, you remove poison.
Antidote.
Yeah.
Yeah, you make it to your dad.
Yep.
His eyes are already glass.
Son of a bitch.
He is dead like a doornail. Yep.
The king is dead, he says.
Long live the king.
Well,
pretty much. And they form up on him, I imagine.
Yeah.
Yep.
The guards immediately kind of look around and form up on Xerxes. Yep.
Ruvel yells, "Get him the fuck out of here."
Yes, sir, they say. Pick his ass up and haul him away from the battlefield. Yep.
They probably take the body mention. Too.
Yeah, well. Yeah, of course.
Yeah.
Yeah, one does haul off bodies. It's not a waste of resources to do that. Remember, this is a universe where necromancers exist. So, you know, no, they pick his ass up and take him off the field, too. You guys are basically lose a bunch of the guards at this point, and Xerxes.
Yeah.
Because they are fucking bailing. Yep.
Well, time for a fighting retreat after we get Ruvel out of the middle of the freaking army enemy.
Yep, pretty much. Crowley, it's your turn.
All right. I'm going to similarly attack the next guy closest to between me and Ruvel.
Okay, roll the hit.
I don't have...
my brain?
Well, he sort of does look... well, not anymore. He used to look like the Scarecrow. Not so much anymore.
No, now he looks like this Sasquatch.
That's probably more accurate.
My acrobatics check is 31.
Yep, no problem. You make it look easy, bouncing over there.
Hmm. And then a 10 and a 22.
Okay, the 10 misses, the 22 hits.
Okay. Oh, sorry, one more for my bite. Woo! Okay, one claw missed, one claw hit, and a bite for double damage.
Bite for double damage. Bite for crit,
bites,
rather, right? Threat.
Yeah, it was a natural
20. Yeah, natural 20.
Ah.
Okay,
roll to confirm.
Okay. No, I don't think the 2 confirms.
Are you going to re-roll that?
Okay.
Don't forget, Crowley, you're hasted, so you get an extra claw.
And a plus 1 to attack.
Okay.
Yeah, okay, I know what I'm gonna do.
Another 22.
Okay, yep.
I can run critical with...
Alright, so let's have some piercing critical.
Fight attack. And he gets another claw attack.
Yeah, and one more claw attack, yep.
Which means he could still get a rake in there.
He could.
Yep, if he hits with this one, he'll get a rake in.
And that hits.
Okay. So now you do a rake attack.
Okay.
Yeah, so that's an extra, right?
Yeah, it's extra.
So, where's my...
Not yet, Stretch, not us.
Critical is slashing. No.
Piercing.
Well,
he gets his choice, actually. It's a bite attack, so it's slashing, piercing, bludgeoning, and he gets his choice of them.
Oh.
Or natural. Isn't there one for natural attacks?
No, not for crits. There is one for fumbles. Okay, you got your choice of Bell Ringer, which is normal damage and 1d2 intelligence damage and sickened for 1d4 rounds. Knock that back. 1d double damage and target is pushed 1d6 squares directly away. Or paper cut, normal damage and -4 penalty on attack rolls, skill checks, and ability checks for 1d4 rounds.
The one that's going to toss him at his buddies, because I'm going to be bouncing off of him like I did the other guy.
Yep. Yep. So you hit him for double damage.
Okay. So 6.3, 4.
That's for the bite.
Double bite damage, yeah.
Double bite damage would be 6.
Okay.
And, 6 on the claw attacks.
Okay, and your rake attack? 6 each on the claw attacks?
No, 6 altogether. Okay. It's only a d3 for each.
Yeah.
But the rake cleaned house. Nine.
So 6, 12, 21 damage.
Nice.
And roll a d6.
2.
Ooh, he's throwing 10 feet backwards.
Well. Yeah, he crashes into the priest who was casting a spell behind him, knocking him prone.
Have I opened up a window for Ruabel to get out of there?
Yes, you have.
Okay.
Good.
All right, and that ends that round. So we'll move on to the other group. You guys managed to collect yourselves out of the hutch and looking around. The wreck of the ship was lying all around you. You guys are on solid ground, fortunately. You were actually kind of on the beach. One more second and you guys would have been in the ocean.
Well, that's fortuitous, says Bonvin, as she closes up the hutch and puts the key in her pocket, since, you know...
Is everyone all right? Asked the king. Who's not the fucking king?
We seem to be.
A little dinged up, but I think we'll be all right. My sister has been teleported to Dad, which means she's probably actually pretty seriously injured, but I can't think of a better place for her to be if so.
Von Ben nods.
You called a rescue. How long before we can expect it? ETA for the rescue squad, says Celine over the bug suit.
6 seconds.
Pretty much now, she says. And that's when you guys, if you figured out your landing plan, show up. I know you were talking about it, so... So what happens when you land? Feel free to describe.
Mm-hmm.
Incoming!
Clear the area, clear the area, says Celine, booking it out of the way.
Yep.
Oh, yeah.
Giving the king a shove in front of her.
Yeah.
Strut, I think Strut should have to make a piloting check.
Can you do something on approach? Yes, and you can either use pilot or fly. I think those were the skills we said were relevant. I don't know if you have either. Does Oleander have training with a bug suit?
Yes.
Oh, he did get training with a bug suit?
I thought he might have.
Oh, yes.
I thought he might have, yes. So, yes, go ahead, Stretch. What are you doing on approach? Look for the densest concentration of troops and cast this just above, timed to dissipate just before I land, okay? Conjure deadfall.
Get away from there. Now.
Banshee?
No, it's not Banshee.
Oh, it's not.
Thank you, Stretch. That helps to have a link.
Yeah?
Holy shit, Birds. You're an asshole, Stretch. I love it.
Oh, jeez.
Okay, what spell is this?
Oh, Pride.
Conjure Deadfall. There's a link.
I missed the link because I wasn't on the page, sadly, so...
Here, I'll send it to you, Tess.
Yeah, but it's dissipating, so everyone goes, fuck, and then it disappears. Hey, Pride, good to see you.
Hello, Pride.
Hey, Jane. How you doing, kid?
I DM'd it to you in Discord, Tess.
Yeah, I see it.
Yeah, I can also cast a spell and strike once with a sword as two-weapon fighting as a magus. Yes, that's true. Taz has used that to great effect a few times, actually.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah.
He's a pretty impressive combatant, actually.
And it's a suboptimal feat spread because I've been grabbing crafting feats.
Oh, I'm sorry, Pride.
Sorry, you were not feeling good there, Pride.
Hugs to you, hun. I say hun as my son.
Oh, Jesus.
Okay, do you really want me to do that right now, Eli, or do you want to stick around for the last half hour of the game?
Oh,
because I will.
Eli! Get some writing done while you listen to this stream.
Send home. Out.
There you go.
Yeah.
Okay, if you're sticking around, Eli, get some writing done. Yeah, the rescue rabblers land on a loose line on the beach. Dazzle lands the skid and skis along the sand for about 20 feet, coming to a stop after kicking up sand that sprays across those waiting to be rescued.
Deadfall of 10 feet deals one per two castles.
Bob.
Well, you guys know how to make an entrance, says Celine.
that death ball is actually incredibly powerful. Especially once you get to some of the bigger sizes. Sure, it does less damage, but it makes it so they can't save.
All right. Says Vonden, we need to get moving.
Yeah. Yeah, let's get out of here before a landing party arrives.
Exactly.
Okay, take the king with you, she says. Loads him up on the skid.
Mm-hmm.
I don't like our chances going over the ocean with things this far from the battle. She says, I'd like to hear your thoughts. Do we head back to the ship or do we head back to the city?
King says, they'll be retreating out of the city by now. He says, we'll head back to your ship.
Was there a rendezvous point, she says to him?
Yes.
We'll join them there. Where are we going?
He tells you.
Okay. Yes, you're going into, or deeper into the forest.
Mm-hmm.
A magically protected city that I haven't named yet, but I'll have a name by next time.
Yeah.
Yeah. All right, so that's where you guys head. Do you need to roll anything? No, no, not right now. There, stretch, that was pretty fancy.
We escaped.
Scattered the fucking group.
Yep.
So if a 15 does 1d6 per...
Yeah, you squish some enemy troops that had landed. Apparently they were pursuing the ship.
I'm just...
In the meantime, in space, you guys can see that basically the fleet is getting pounded.
Mm-hmm. Xerxes calls a retreat. The city is lost.
Didn't somebody like whack Xerxes over the head and haul him off the battlefield?
Yes. No, they didn't. They didn't whack him on the head. They just started, picked him up and started carrying him away.
Yep.
So he could still call the retreat.
He could. He is still in a bug suit.
Yep.
Arian don't want to retreat.
Neither do Ruavel.
It's more about who's the surviving senior nobility person in town.
Yeah.
The Majorman doesn't leave the field until he knows Xerxes is clear.
Yeah, that's what I was gonna basically. I got one more spell that I can cast on myself to increase my speed by another 30 feet, so I'm good. Like, I can get the hell out of dodge when I need to. I got an expeditious retreat ready.
So the question stands, who's the senior noble in town at this point since they already hauled Xerxes off?
That'd be you, I think.
I think that's you, actually.
Yeah.
Let me think about that. Yeah, I think it is, because none of the princesses are there. Ruavel is only a lord. You're a duke.
Yeah, you're a duke.
Yep, you are in charge.
Yep, it falls to me to hold the rear guard. Everybody out.
Yep. Everybody out. Falls to him to hold the rear guard. There's Ruavel staying with him.
This is so the Dreamland.
Get out. Says Ruavel.
Expeditious retreat to be cast on other people, yeah?
Yeah, I think so.
I'll check here.
Okay, I see Stretch's Thor-style superhero landing, which is awesome. Daz says, wait, has it been declared over the bug suit comms that Xerxes is now king? What you heard over the comms was this. The king is dead. That was Xerxes. Response from Arden, long live the king. Right? Then you heard from Ruvel, get him the fuck out of here. Aye, sir. People grabbed, and then as far as you know, they obeyed. Right? So that is what you heard. So I think, yes, it is reasonable for you to have had enough information to infer that Xerxes is now king. You do hear Xerxes say, call the retreat. We're retreating. The city is lost. Right? That also made it through over the bug suits. Right? Yeah. So I think you know. Yeah.
And now he has a bunch of pissed off.
Yeah, hold the retreat.
Mm-hmm. I'll cast Expeditious Retreat on Arian then, so he can get that extra movement speed to get out.
I already have the boots, thanks.
Oh, well then I'll cast it on the other person who's staying behind.
Ruvel, yeah.
Ruvel. That way they can get out the hell out of Dodge.
Alessander, at this point, orders the ship to come out of the shadow and make their way, avoiding debris, towards the city. Daz is like, who are we escorting? The princesses. They were separated. Well, I guess you don't know that they're princesses. Well, you do, actually. Daz is the only one of the regular chat crew who does. Well, except for Oleander. Stretch.
Yeah.
Yep, Oleander. Get to the king! Yes. And but you know that Celine, Von Vin, and them are Imperial princesses. You were there to overhear that. You haven't told anybody else, as far as I know.
Nope. She knows the problem.
Right. Celine said, because she heard the order, right? She said, do you want to go back to the city or the ship? Right? And then she heard the order and she said, is there a rendezvous point? Right? After she was told the city was lost. Right? The guy we thought was the king says yes. Right? She says, where is it? He tells her. She says, that's where we're going. Let's move. You found them, Stretch. You're where they are. Celine is one of them, right? Obviously. Yeah, Von Vin is another. The third one, Yasma, is not currently on the field. But you did... Actually, no, he did not overhear. He did not overhear that she had been teleported away.
Yeah, he did. You're in your bug suit.
He was not in the bug suit when that happened because he was told to get into it afterwards because he's wearing Alessander's bug suit.
Right.
So, I have a question.
Yes.
Given the fact that I'm a duke and that we had days to plan for all of this shit.
Yep.
I assume I was taken into confidence on all the plans. Is there a... Yes. Go to hell, blow the city up thing that we're supposed to do if the city is lost.
These are elves. Almost certainly.
I believe there's a hearthstone we have to grab.
Right? Yes.
And the city will basically collapse in on itself without the hearthstone.
Oh, that's where we're headed. As part of the covering the retreat.
Yeah.
Okay, fortunately, you are right there, because you're basically right near the castle, and it is in the bowels of the castle. You guys know that.
Yep. So that's where we're headed.
Okay. Okay, you guys over on the beach... fuck off towards the rendezvous point, which is deep within a rather sylvan forest. Yep. The ship with people on it heads down towards the planet. They're still invisible at this point, I remind you. That's why Alessandra was like, and be careful not to hit any debris. You guys head for the interior of the castle. Nobody stops you. You do get a couple of crossbow bolts shot in your general direction as you flee the field, but...
Awesome. I'm watching their back. Even though I'm leaving the field, I'm still watching their back.
Yeah, and you can. You have a ranged attack. Go
yes,
ahead.
Yes, I do.
Make your attack.
This is gonna bloody hurt. They have a DC 20.
Okay.
And they will be taking 5d10 points of damage.
Ooh, fuck me. Okay. That's a bad day.
Yeah, the DC 20 will save.
Okay. Name generator, City of Silverwood. Sure. Seems a good name for it. We'll call it Silverwood. I'll translate that into Elvish in a little while. I think if I remember correctly, how would that be? Arasil, I think. Silverwood. Okay. You guys head off. You guys are heading in to the castle.
These guys are going to have a headache.
These guys definitely have a headache. Couple of them fall right over with, like, blood coming out of their ears. Are you heading with them to the hearthstone, or are you...
I'm heading the other way. That's why I was watching
people...
their back.
Okay, so you're organizing a retreat, okay?
Yep.
How will I do this?
Sorry, guys. My mom called, and I had to take the call.
No worries, we were thinking, so. I think maybe make a luck roll. Arian
Four.
Can make it. How long you've got before they start blowing up the castle, basically.
Yep.
Okay, D27.
You reroll that.
17.
Much better.
That's better.
Okay, you guys manage to get into the castle before anything major happens and head down into the basement.
Mm-hmm.
Where you happen to know that there is a, you know, sort of a focus room area.
Yep.
You guys managed to grab the hearthstone. Now, make a luck roll to see if you can get out of here before the castle falls in on you.
You want to roll that one, Aaron?
Sure, I'll roll that one. I rolled 15 on the die.
Yeah, things start to rumble.
Yeah, they're hitting the castle with fucking siege rounds now.
Yep.
Well, that we just pulled out the magic that's holding it up.
Yep.
Yep.
Ruvel's like, move.
Yeah, vacate,
into the jungle.
Let's go.
Yeah, you guys start flying out of the fucking castle as fast as you can for the immediate exit. Fortunately, Ruvel happens to know where the secret exit from the castle is.
Yep.
Isn't that handy?
Follow me, he says to Arian.
Dawn.
Take it right out of the city.
Yep, it does indeed lead out of the city, as you well know. You can feel the ground kind of rumbling around you, and you can hear distant noises and whatnot.
Probably magical mouths all over the city screaming, get the fuck out of here, and haven't already left.
Yep.
This is not a drill.
Those of you on the ship see the city. Okay, so basically what happens is there's like all kinds of orc ships and whatnot in the sky around the city. They are dropping siege weaponry on the city. You know, big catapult rocks and shit, right? There's people running and screaming. Right, you see, you know, everybody start heading for the edge of the city. Right, you don't hear the magic mouths, you're too far away. Right, and then a few minutes later, there's an enormous flash. It's like, it causes green spots on your eyes, it's so bright. Then you hear, because you have hit atmosphere by this point, a distant whoom. And the whole city basically implodes.
Many orc ships get dug under.
Quite a few of them do, yes. A few seem to manage to fly away, right? You even feel the pull yourself. Alessander says evasive maneuvers. And the city collapses.
Yeah. As Mariama yawns, goes, what? It just kind of twitches the ship to the side.
Pretty much. And guys, I realize that it's still 12 minutes to 9 o'clock, but this seems like a great place to call it.
Yep.
So that's what we're doing. Good work tonight, everybody. That was fun as hell.
I think that deserves a level.
I think it do.
For chat crew too.
Yep, for chat crew too. And you get a level, and you get a level, and you get a level.
All right. Everybody gets a level.
Yay for level 10. Oh boy.
Yeah.
I'll have to go and do a bunch of stuff now. Yay.
I have to go do a bunch of stuff. Crowley with the face rip, I know, right? Epic.
Don't forget to go by Dawn and Blake and get new character sheets over at Aaron and Sable and Siobhan's.
Yeah, we'll try to find some time this weekend.
Awesome.
No, Magpie, I don't remember where Nimlin is from.
Alatha.
Alatha. No, not Alatha. Alasia. Sorry.
Alasia
on Draconia. The capital city. Bob's like, okay, so the orcs didn't take the city, so we win, right? Right?
Yes and no. It's called like a Pyrrhic loss.
I love it. Stretch.
Pyrrhic victory on the orcs part.
I love what Stretch does here. Stretch says, Oleander stands, just frozen on the spot, staring on in horror. He's not usually fazed by anything but this, then bows his head and carries on. You see that Celine also stops and stares for a moment. And then when you move on, she's like, let's go.
We're generally in Wolf, but he doesn't have time. He's got to get out of the city.
Her voice is a little choked. Yeah. Good work. That was fun. Thank you guys so much. I had a great time.
Unfortunately, we're in the tunnel and then in the woods, so we probably don't see the city go under.
Nope. No, you do not. Clock Rocket says, thanks for the broadcast. I'm going to head to bed for a little bit. Have a good sleep. Realm says, thanks for the broadcast. Thank you guys for hanging out with us and listening to our game.
Yeah.
We had a fairly big crowd tonight, actually. At one point, we had 16 or 17 people. That's a pretty large group for this particular broadcast, and I appreciate it.
Mm-hmm. Have a good night, guys.
Yeah, good night, guys. Thanks for joining us. Anybody got last-minute thoughts or commentary before we head to the closeout screen?
Not me.
No.
No. We're all good.
Yep.
Okay. Yeah. Except for Eli, who is writing. Yeah, that's right. Okay, who's up? I imagine Coffee's up. Yes, Coffee is up.
That's about it.
That's about it. Okay, I guess we're rating Coffee. I got 160 words in. Excellent. All right, yes, and remember, our raid call is prepare to be boarded, for we are the Sable's privateers. All right. Toy Soldiers Old School is game mastered for the moment by Sable Radia, created by Diane Morrison. Audio and video provided by Zoom. Sound effects and ambience provided by Sirenscape. Music provided by Whitesand. Check out his Patreon at patreon.com/whitesand. Character images by HeroForge. Mapping software by Campaign Cartographer 3+, World Spinner and Incarnate with adaptations in Adobe Photoshop. Gaming software provided by Fantasy Grounds, Hero Lab, and World Anvil. Check out our campaign at www.worldanvil.com/w/Toy Soldier Saga. The Toy Soldier Saga is copyright 1995 by Diane Morrison, all rights reserved. Thank you all so much for joining us tonight. I had a lot of fun. Monday is our day off. Tuesday, Aaron will be back for Ask an Old GM at 2 p.m. Pacific, 5 p.m. Eastern, 10 p.m. UTC and in the UK, 7 o'clock in the morning on Wednesday for those of you in Australian Eastern Time. And we're about to raid Coffee Quills. Don't forget to shout, prepare to be boarded, because we are the Sable's privateers, and we'll see y'all next week. Thanks for joining us tonight.
Hey, one more level and I get two more levels and I get it.